Hello, darkness, my old friend. I've come to talk with you again.
Just kidding. Come over here. I've got something to show you. I think everybody's ready for a little bit of positivity. And that's what I want to open today's video with. I just want to say thank you for the outpouring of support, of encouragement, all of you out there that have been following us for years, and some of you over a decade. It's been incredible. Just 2 days ago, we released this video, Should I Quit?, where I talked about the history of Essential Tennis, also where we are now, the changes we've been going through, and just the feedback, the comments, which I read every single comment. The thumbs up have been incredible. I just want to let you all know, I've never felt more supported and more loved and kind of held closely by our online community than I have in the last 48 hours. And so thank you so much for that. And so my question in that video was, what's next? Like, what should we focus on? And I gave three ideas of my own, but then I opened it up to all of you. And so as I was going through the comments below the video that we released earlier this week, I just started making a tally. And so every time there was something new, I wrote it down, and then I just put a little check mark next to each one. So you can see a clear pattern here. There were a few suggestions that obviously had way more positive feedback than the other ones. And so I've taken these, and by the way, I just think it was kind of maybe funny or tragic or however you want to look at it. The stuff we've been focusing on mostly in the past, this category here, general technique requests, anytime somebody asks for like, oh, I want to learn how to whatever, hit a buggy whip forehand or anything specific, like any kind of technical thing, was a pretty small minority out of all the different feedback. And for Essential Tennis, I feel like we've kind of been stuck in a rut, really focusing on that type of content for quite a while. And we've also been doing this type of content, working with students in person. We've been doing a lot of that as well. And so, you know, I would say there was medium feedback for those types of videos in the future, moving forwards. But what was really clear was you all want to see some kind of personal story. You want to see me tackle my own challenges, my own issues, be able to go out and play against other players, have that struggle, have that challenge of maybe entering a tournament or having some kind of goal. And so that really was the big breakout type of topic. The only thing that really stood out that didn't involve me and like challenging myself was looking at strategy in general. And we've done strategy in the past, but not a lot of it. We've really been focused mainly on the technique stuff, has really been our main focus. So when we break this down and look at the top four, these are the top four things that were voted for. Number one, and I talked about this in the previous video, the My Crappy Backhand piece of content that we did a little bit over a year ago, where I worked on my biggest weakness, my backhand. That had the most votes. And my idea there was just to go through kind of stroke by stroke, figure out what my flaws are, and then work on fixing them here on the Essential Tennis Court. And that had a ton of positive feedback. You all watching obviously would like to see me go through that process. The number two was the strategy. And this was a mix of let us send in videos of ourselves playing singles and doubles and do a breakdown of that. And with this new equipment that we recently got and kind of a new setup here, that would be really fun to do. I can bring up clips here on the screen and draw on the screen and do breakdowns of patterns and targets and that sort of thing. And so that was the second most popular choice. Number three was me playing tournaments. And I feel like number one and number three kind of go together, working on my own game and then going out, enlisting in tournaments, registering for tournaments, recording it, and then come back and report. Like, here's the match, recording it whenever possible. In fact, I probably wouldn't play a tournament if I didn't have explicit permission to record. And I don't know how all that's going to go yet, but that would be my goal. I don't want to go and play if it's just like a selfie video of me like in the parking lot in my car being like, whoa, I lost, guys. Like, I really want to be able to really document it and show it to you guys. And then the fourth one was more confessional cam matches. And that's where we shot here in our court. We had cameras like set up in the corners, and me and Kevin, or me and Scott from Play Your Court, we played each other and just breaking down. Here's what I'm thinking. Here's what I'm feeling. These are the tactical adjustments I'm going to make. All right, let's go out, play the next two games and see what happens. So these are the top four. And so these were like clear standout choices. And so now what I would love to get from you guys is a vote. Which of those four do you want to see next? And based on the results, based on the response of all of you down below this video, I'm going to go ahead and choose which thing we're going to focus on next. So leave your response down below. I'm really curious to see what you think. And if you enjoy this engagement, this interaction, do me a favor and just click like. It really does actually help the videos and the channel out a lot. So click that like button if you appreciate this back and forth. I'm looking forward to diving into whichever of those four things ultimately gets chosen, I'm excited about. And I'm sure we'll be doing a mix of all of those in the coming weeks and months. Thank you again so much for your support. It means the world to me. And I'll see you in the next video.